fisheries and ranchers to bring you all the ingredients you need to create incredible home-cooked meals. The ingredients come paired with an easy-to-follow recipe card delivered to your door weekly in a refrigerated box. Rediscover how fun cooking can be while enjoying specialty ingredients and exploring new flavors and cuisines. Get your first three Blue Apron meals free plus free shipping by visiting blueapron.com/radiolab.
Hey, I'm Jan Abumrad.
I'm Robert Coach.
This is Radio Lab, and today we're talking about color.
Okay.
And that actually brings us back to Jay Metz.
I'm a professor of ophthalmology at the University of Washington, Seattle.
Jay has actually spent his entire career trying to get creatures to see colors they normally can't see. He started, this is kind of a story, by taking some colorblind monkeys who couldn't see red.
They have blue collars, green collars, but no red collars.
Which is not unlike a lot of people. In any case, he gets monkeys and was able to take the human gene for the red cone, wrap it in a virus, inject it into the monkey's eyes, and bam, the monkeys suddenly had red cones.
Yeah. Oh. So it had blue, green, and red.
Is this like LASIK? So it's just like a 10-minute outpatient situation for the monkeys?
I would say close. Close to LASIK.
Could they then now see red?
Well, every single morning before they get their breakfast, they have to do their color vision test. So
we'd sit each monkey at it.
We had a touch screen.
And the screen looks totally red. But in that field of red, he adds a little red blob.
Right.
Now here's the key.
We use grape juice as the reinforcement for monkey. But
game is.
You have to touch the blob before you get your juice.
So before the surgery, they weren't seeing any blobs, and they weren't getting any juice. Because all they could see was gray, so a little red blob would be right there in front of them, and they'd never see it. And the morning after their LASIK color booster shot, they still couldn't see it. Day after day, they would do their test, and every day they would fail.
Every day they would fail.
No blob. No juice.
But it's fun for them. They get out of their cage and they talk to their friends.
Did you fail?
Yeah, I failed.
Another day, another fail. Until one morning, after about 20 weeks, they woke up the monkeys, gave them the test.
And they began to not fail.
Really?
If you watch the video of this, it actually looks like the monkey is like,
wow, no, I'm not having any failures.
And check out this dot. Look at this thing.
Check it out.
Well, so, I did get some sense that they felt like that their life had improved.
Now, if this works so well with the monkeys, couldn't you take a colorblind human and give them back the thing they're missing?
Absolutely. We could cure colorblindness in a human with exactly this technique. The only thing that we have to do is convince the FDA that the risks are low enough and the benefit is high enough that it'd be something we could do in people.
You've never tried it?
No, we've never tried it. Although I get a lot of emails that say, I don't care what the risks are. I've even had offers. How about if I come to your laboratory and you don't tell anybody late at night and you give me the shot in the eye, we won't tell anybody.
Which brings us back to our original question. If you can take a colorblind human and give them normal color vision, could you take a normal color seer and boost them to make them a little more sure?
Well, yes, yeah.
I said, sure, why not? Then there's the whole FDA. But here's the real surprise.
Jay says there are some people who are already a little bit mantis shrimp-like. There are color mutants, in the nicest possible way, among us.
Or they're out there in theory. Okay, so here's the deal. The genes for the cones in our eyes that see color, you know, red, green, blue cones,
yeah,
they're on the X chromosome. Now men, as we know, only have one of those.
Women have two X chromosomes.
Which means that women have two sets of these cone-making genes. Normally one set is just a spare, it's not used, but still they've got two sets.
And so someone said, aha!
It is theoretically possible that someone with this spare set of genes might mix up, turn on, morph, into a whole new cone, a fourth cone.
We're going to call it the yellow cone.
So people with normal